right, folks, we are inside the Fort video office.
Just check this out, like old school bathrooms and
old school guns. And...
oh, boy.
That was awesome.
Thank you so much, sir.
We made it when we did.
Everything
coming on the Fort. Why not? I'll do it myself or put it on your head. The map of the mountains, folks. And where Fort Riverdale is located. Old school guns, and you got all kinds of stuff in here, but we are going to head out and show you guys inside the fort. Everybody, let's head outside. Come on, Matt. Riley, let's go. Actually, here. We're going to show you viewers the fort. That's right. We're going to go in the fort itself. Fort's that way, Brad.
Gentlemen, I hate to tell you, these are not French muskets. There was a Charleville musket, and then the Pennsylvania long rifle was made here in Pennsylvania, east of here. And that's how the Charleville and the muskets were long rangers.
Right.
He told me which one that one first.
So this is the one thing George Washington was.
Lead the way, Brad. Yep, Brad knows a lot about this too, man.
Yep.
Rattler, whatever the hell you call yourself on here, Rattler or Matt or...
it's always Rattler.
I know, bud. I'm only picking on you, bud. Alright, so, we're getting ready to head inside the fort, folks.
We are going inside the fort.
I'm surprised there ain't no cicadas down this direction. There's woods all around here, too, Brad. We're in the fort, guys. Talk about history. You ain't gonna get better history than this.
No.
This is incredible. How you doing, man? Really awesome.
Wow.
Sure thing here, buddy.
What did the Pennsylvania rifle used in the Revolutionary War with General Washington?
That was the rifle light. Walk over here.
And oh, here you go, Matty.
Yes, sir. How cool is this?
Okay. This here is a Lancaster style, Revolutionary, Redding style long rifle. It was made in the 1770 style. That would be pretty close to what a rifleman would have carried. And there would be some variations of it. But up to about 300 yards, you can adjust someone's attitude.
We ought to check out the cabin houses. That would be awesome.
The average person is in the Revolutionary War.
Cool gun, man.
Really cool. He has one. I have one that's a little more French influenced.
Wow.
Which would be the Charleville musket. No, Charleville musket was an actual brand that came from France.
That's the brand name of the gun, right?
Yes, it was actually Charlottesville was the town it was made in. And actually, it's the armory it was in France.
That was the French musket.
Because I was watching a long time ago about General George Washington going up against Napoleon.
Check these old school cabin houses out. Wow, look at this, guys. This was life back in the 1800s. Old school tables and the old school roofs, and this is how they made their fireplaces back in the 1800s, and the steps to go up to the second floor. Just check it out. This was life back before when they had electricity. Back when they used like lanterns and candles, and you can see the candle on the table and lantern candlelight right there. And how cool was that? Totally nice. Checking out the cabin houses. Really nice. go inside this one. Wow, this must be the supply shop.
That is the supply shop. Are they getting it? Look.
Let's shine a little light on the situation.
Look at this history here.
Salt and pork. This is where they put their meats back then. What do you think of this, Wendy?
She's like, good idea, bro.
you can't ask for any better than this.
This is awesome.
This is better than awesome. Here's the old school lights, the lanterns. Yep. This is what they used in the 1800s before electricity came. They put like gas in here or like wickies or whatever they done. They just lit them on fire, and this is how they had light back in the old days. The good old days. I can see smoke come out of that one, but we're gonna check the other ones out. See how much more history we can run into here. This is awesome. This back then. Dirt floors. These are the beds they use, guys, back then. They made them all out of solid wood. And old cushions, they would use like straws of hay to lay on. And there's a candlelight. And there's a fireplace. And these are the type of games they played back then. Old school type chess. Chess, believe it or not, folks, Miss Rutherford fans, chess is one of the first ever games in the history of the earth. You know that, Wendy, right? Chess and checkers. That's actually checkers. If you look at old school checkers, checkmate. Pew. You know what I mean? I win. Let's check out the next fort. And one more. Next fort. Oh, that one shut off. Yeah, they got it locked. It must be really, really important in there where they have it locked. There's another one down here. How you doing, man? Over there.
The big hut is the officer's quarters. If you notice, there's a bed, a desk, a chair. This is the soldiers. Now.
I see they had old school beds in there. That's incredible.
There's 12 bunks, but there would be 24.
Wow.
They would house 24. So you better like your bunkmate. So there's two men to each bunk.
Oh, yeah.
And then this is the doctor's office, the doctor's quarters.
Oh, over there.
And he's not here today.
So that's why it's locked up.
And right here, so where do they make? Isn't that the woodsmith over there?
Blacksmith.
The blacksmith. Incredible. And what would that hut be over there?
That is the lead miner's house.
Wow.
As the lead, because we're the lead mine fort. The lead mine.
Would it be all right if we check it out?
Sure, that's what it's here for.
All right, thank you, there, bud. Wow.
Yeah, sure. You learned. You're gonna hit the. There we go.
That Powerball. Hit a Powerball of old school. This is pretty cool. Remember, bro, I grew up old school. Wow, you can smell the old hickory here. This be a type of house that an old country boy like me would love to live in. Just look at this. You got the old school tools right here, like the mining kit. This is actually the mining kit. The pickaxes and the shovels and that's all that. Yep, and here's another old school lantern. Look at that, folks, made from a candle. And this one's actually stone floor and benches. See, Wendy, back in the 1800s, they didn't have much cushion. This is what they sat on. Yep. People were a lot tougher back in the old days because they had this hardcore life that made them strong like they are today. Nowadays, everyone's just too soft. I can live like this. I could. I love it. Put me out in the woods and I live like this. I love this. Look at that old school ladder hanging on top. Folks, tip in. Fort Riverdale. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. That's a surprise for you guys tonight. So stay tuned. Subscribe. And this rocker as we head on out.